Hi, I'm Xavier. This is our product manager, Eric.
Hi.
Today we are going to introduce a few new products.
Yeah, but before that, I have to apologize to all customers who have ordered the recomputed case. Because of the COVID-19 related issue, production and shipment was delayed. We have shipped 100 sets already, and the rest will be shipped by the end of this month.
We also shared the STR document of our case design, right?
Yeah, it's a 3D print document. Actually, if you download the document and print it out, it will look like this. It works the same way as the case you ordered, but it's 3D printed.
Okay, how to put this computer into this case?
Well, the usage of it is quite simple. First, you remove the top and put the module on the base. Then stack back the middle frame and tighten the screws. There are four screws. We use the M3 screws, so just tighten them and put back the top. Okay, so what's that?
Okay, so which product we are going to talk about today?
The first one is the stack up case for recomputer.
I think we just talking about a case, right?
Yeah, but that's a different thing. This module is for you to expand your recomputer case.
So I can add some extra components in this case?
Yeah, absolutely. The usage is quite simple. You just put this stack case on top of your original case. And then see, you have extra space for you to put some disks. You can even put a RAID array into it.
That's great. I think it's a must buy for those who use Odyssey XDCs as NAS store.
Absolutely. The next thing is the Seeeduino Beaglebone Green Gateway.
I remember we have Beaglebone Green and Beaglebone Green Wireless.
Yeah, these two are available on our site for many years. And they are quite popular among the community, but this one is quite different.
What's the edge of this one?
Compared with BBGW, it has a Ethernet connector. And compared with BBG, it has a Bluetooth and Wi-Fi module.
So this is what is called gateway.
Yeah, it's a true gateway. Besides, it has a DC power jack. So when it's deployed into production environment, it's more stable and robust.
Great, those who bought BBG or want to get one must take this into consideration.
Exactly. And this is the new Ameba development board we bought from Realtek. It's RTL8722DM.
Okay, I saw it has two MCUs on board.
Yeah, one is ARM VAM, Cortex M33 instruction set compatible, running up to 200 MHz. Another is Cortex M23 IS compatible and running up to 20 MHz.
Okay. So it's a high performance board.
Yes, but it also works at ultra low power and has onboard dual band Wi-Fi.
What's dual band?
It means it can work at 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz, both of them. So it's called dual band. And powered by this strong Wi-Fi and Realtek's mature audio codec technology, it can perform high resolution and super low latency audio transmission.
How low?
As little as 16 milliseconds.
Wow, it will be a great option for IoT development.
Absolutely. Now we are going to take a look at what our users have done with our Seeeduino Xiao. Xiao is quite popular among the community, and there must be a lot to discover.
Wow, I can't wait to see.
Okay, the first one is from our Twitter user, Homemade Garbage. How to read it?
MIDI USB library 使って非常に小さくて可愛い MIDI デバイスを手にした。
Okay, what did he mean?
It means that Seeeduino Xiao is very small, cute.
Okay, so he used the Xiao as a MIDI device, right?
Yes.
Okay, then next one. Okay, this is from our Twitter user, Gary Kelly. You can now run Rust embedded on the $5 Seeeduino Xiao without much hassle. He also provided us a link. Let's see, what is it? Wow, so he adds Seeeduino Xiao support for the Rust language. This is a lot of effort. Well, thanks to Kelly. You've done a great job.
Yeah, it's so cool.
Okay, the next one. This is from Andy Warburton. He built a simple USB HID Macropad using Seeeduino Xiao and CircuitPython. So, do you know what's a Macropad?
No, I don't know.
Well, actually, some users want to separate certain keys off their keyboard to integrate them into one pad, and they will make a Macropad. This is quite useful, right?
Yes, it's quite useful.
Okay, the next one.
これは Yasuhiro さんからの Twitter です。シャオ買ってみた小さくて可愛い値段も安いし、パゲージも書きピンっぽくて可愛い。次は日本のユーザーのナナシさんがStuno シャオについてブログで詳しいご紹介です。文章にはシャオのスペックや特徴を説明しただけではなく、シリアル通信の速度の計測を行い、簡単な SPI と UART のユースケースも作成されました。素晴らしい文章なので、C の公式ウィキにこの文章を英語に翻訳して通過しておりました。シャオのこの情報を了解したいなら、日本での皆さん、ぜひこの記事を参考にしてください。ここで奈々歳さんにもう一度感謝します。もちろん、あなたが C 製品の関連記事を発表したら、ぜひ私たちに連絡して一緒にオープンソースハットウェアの開発に力を入れましょう。以上です。Is that all?
Yeah, this is everything we have today.
So, hope you guys like it. See you next week.
See ya.
Bye.